Hello students, today we will learn about Boolean algebra, which is the last topic of your unit 4. So Boolean algebra is a branch of maths which we use to analyze the digital gates and circuit in digital electronics. We use Boolean algebra. So there are only two variables in digital logic gates. One is 0 and another is 1. So all digital electronics is based on 0 and 1. So in many case, 0 denotes for low and 1 denotes for high. So if somewhere is low voltage, so in digital electronics we denote it by 0, and if some place there is high voltage, so we denote it by 1. So as in simple algebra there are many laws, similarly in Boolean algebra there are many Boolean's law. So first one is commutative law. So if A and B are two variable, then commutative law says that A plus B is equal to B plus A. This means if we add A plus B, and in another case we add B plus A, so both will be give same value. Similarly for multiplication, this commutative law is A dot B equal to B dot A. This means if we multiply A and B, or we multiply B and A, this will give same result. Second law is associative law. So the associative law is both for addition and multiplication. So for addition, this law says that A plus B and plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. This means if we add A plus B first and then we add C, this will be equal to A, and plus if we add B plus C combined. So similarly for multiplication, this will be A dot B dot C equal to A dot B dot C. This means if we multiply B dot C then A, this will be equal to if we multiply A dot B and then C. Third one is distributive law. This say that A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. Now there are some AND law and some OR law. So AND laws says there are four laws. So this says that if we multiply any variable with 0, this will give result always 0. Similarly if we multiply any variable by 1, this will give same variable A. Third one is if we multiply two same variables A dot A, this will give value equal to A. And if we multiply A by its complement, A bar denotes complement. So if we multiply A by its complement, this will give 0. So AND law are, you can consider basically the law with multiplication. So if we multiply any variable with 0, this will give 0. If we multiply any variable by 1, this will give same variable A. If we multiply two same variable, this will give same variable. And if we multiply any variable by its complement, this will give 0. Where this A bar is called complement of A and denoted by variable A and a bar just above it. So there are OR law. These are related to addition. So these laws say that if we add 0 to any variable, this will give same variable. If we add 1 to some variable A, this will give result 1. If we add a variable A with its complement A bar, this will always give A. And if we this is the same rule. So these are three OR law. And last one is inverse law. Inverse law means if we inverse complement of any variable, this will give result to So now comes the logic gates. So logic gate are building blocks of the digital system or digital electronics. These gates always work on some logic, and there are two or more inputs and one output. So output depend on the different logic. So based on the logic, the gates are divided in AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, AND gate, and NOR gate. So there are these five types of gates depending on different type of logics. So first type of gate is AND gate. So in AND gate there are two or more variables or more inputs and one output. And we denote AND gate by this type of sign. These A and B are two inputs. This show the symbolic presentation of AND gate, and this Y is the output of this gate. So AND gate have two input, in this case A and B, and output Y denoted by Y. There may be more than one two inputs. So in this case we have considered only two inputs A and B. So the logic for the output in this case is Y equal to A dot B. So output Y for AND gate is A dot B. So if we define truth table for the AND gate, so first what is truth table? So as we know that there are only two variables in digital electronics, 0 and 1. So truth tables represent the output for different combination of these two variables, 0 and 1. So let we have to find the truth table for AND gate. So as we know that output of AND gate is A dot B. So we have written here input A, B and output Y. So as there are only two possibility, 0 and 1. So there may be four different combination of 0, 1. First, so input A is 0 and input B is 0. Second, input A is 0, input B is 1. Third one may be input A 1, input B 0. And fourth one may be input A equal to 1 and B is also 1. So these four input are possible for 0 and 1. No other inputs are possible other than these four inputs. So sometimes both may be 0, sometimes A may be 0 and B 1, sometimes A 1 and B 0, and in some case A and B both may have value 1. So we have to calculate output for these different combinations. So if A and B both are 0, so output Y A dot B is will it will also 0. So if A is 0, B is 1, so output Y A dot B this will also 0. Similarly, if A is 1, B is 0, so output will again 0. And if A and B both are 1, output A dot B this will be 1. So this is the truth table for AND gate. Now second gate is OR gate. So OR gate also have two or more inputs and one outputs, and this is the symbolic presentation of OR gate, this type. So there are two inputs A and B and one output Y, and the logic for the output Y is given by Y equal to A plus B. So output for OR gate is given by A plus B. So again we have to write truth table for the OR gate. So we have make this table. So there are different combination of input A and B, and this is denotes the output. So there are only four possibility, both may be 0, 1, 0, and B may be 1, A may be 1 and B 0, or both A and B may be 1. So if A and B both are 0, so output Y equal to A plus B will also be 0. If A is 0, B is 1, so output Y A plus B will also be 1. So if A is 1 and B is 0, output again will be 1, and if both are 1, output will be 1 plus 1 and this will equal to 1. So as in digital electronics, there are only two possibility, 0 and 1. So all output must have written in 0 or 1. So 1 plus 1 will be always equal to 1. So another gate is NOT gate. It is also called the inverter gate. And the logic for this NOT gate, we write Y equal to A bar. A bar denotes the complement of A. So this is the symbolic notation of NOT gate, this type of triangle and a small circle on the on this corner, and this is output of Y. So in NOT gate there is only one input and one output. So if we write truth table, so there will be one input A and one output Y. So as there is one input, so there is only two possibilities, A may be 0 or A may be 1. So if A is 0, output will be 1, as it inverts the input. So if A is 1, the output will be 0. So this is called also inverter gate. Inverter gate means it inverts the input. If input is 0, it gives 1, and if input is 1, it gives 0. So the fourth one is NAND gate. So NAND gate is the combination of NOT and AND gates. So this is the notation of NAND gate. So in notation, as it is a combination of NOT and AND gate, so we have made a AND gate and this circle for the NOT gate. So this is the notation for NAND gate. So there are two inputs and one output Y. So the logic for the NAND gate, we can write Y equal to AB and whole bar. This means the output will be complement of A dot B. So if we have to find the truth table for NAND gate, so we have two inputs A and B. There are four combinations for inputs which are possible, 00, 01, 10 and 11. So output is Y equal to AB and whole bar. So first we calculate A dot B. So in this case A dot B will be 0, in this case A dot B will be also 0, in this case also 0, and in this case A dot B will be 1. But we have output Y equal to AB and whole bar, means output is complement of A dot B. So output Y will be AB whole complement. So for this case, if AB is 0, Y will be its complement 1. Again, if in this case Y will be 1, in this case Y will be 1, and in this case AB is 1, so AB bar will be 0, so Y will be 0. So this is the truth table for NAND gate. So to find the truth table, first you have to write the logic, then you have to write different combination of input, and then you have to calculate the output. So last one gate is NOR gate. So as from its name, NOR means NOT plus OR. So it is combination of a NOT gate and a OR gate. So it is denoted by this type of sign. This is OR gate and this is for NOT gate. And the output for NOR gate is given by Y equal to A plus B into whole bar. So as it is clear from the output, as NOR gate is a combination of OR and NOT, so A plus B denotes OR gate operation and the bar denotes NOT gate operation. So output of NOR gate is Y equal to A plus B and whole bar. So let we have to find truth table for the NOR gate. So again we write different combination of A and B, 00, 01, 10 and 11. These are only four possibility that A and B input can have. So if we have to calculate output Y, first we have to calculate A plus B and then we will calculate its complement. So if both are 0, A plus B will be 0. If A is 0, B is 1, A plus B will be 1. Similarly in this case A plus B will be 1, and in this case A plus B will also 1. So as Y, output Y is complement of A plus B. So in this case output will be 1, in this case 0, in this case 0, in this case 0. So this is the output for NOR gate. And these NAND gate and NOR gates are also called the universal gate. Universal gate means any type of gate can be realized by these gates. So NAND gate and NOR gate are called the universal gates. So this is all about the different logic gates and Boolean algebra. So if you have any questions, you can ask me. So thank you.